Hi guys, welcome back. As you know, Windows 10 supports officially ended on 14th October 2025. And many of you upgraded to Windows 11 to see what's new. But after using it for a while, you might feel it's not really your cup of tea. If your apps are not working properly or the performance is not great, and you want to go back to the Windows 10 without losing your license key. So let's get started and see how to safely downgrade it from Windows 11 back to Windows 10. So before we begin, let's quickly check which version you are currently running. So press Windows plus R on your keyboard to open the run dialog box. And here you need to type Winver and hit enter. A small windows will appear showing your Windows version. Here you can see I am using version 2.4.2. Okay, so once you have confirmed that, let's move on. Now, before you downloading anything, let's check if your system still has the official rollback options. When you upgrade from Windows 10 to Windows 11, Windows automatically keeps a copy of your old operating system for a limited time, usually for 10 days. During that period, you can easily go back to Windows 10 without reinstalling anything manually. Okay, so to check this, right-click on the Start menu, then choose Setting. On the left-hand side, click on System. Then scroll down and click Recovery. Under the Recovery options, look for a button called Go Back or Roll Back to Windows 10. If you see that option, perfect. Just click it and follow the on-screen instruction, and Windows will restore your old setup automatically. However, if it's been more than 10 days, you won't find that options anymore because Windows delete those old files after that period. But don't worry, we can still reinstall Windows 10 safely using the official setup file directly from Microsoft. So for that, you need to open Google Chrome or any browser you like and search for Windows 10 download. Click on the official Microsoft link, and on that page, Microsoft usually shows a tool called the Media Creation Tool, but we need the direct setup download options. So if you don't see it, here is a simple trick. Okay, so right click anywhere blank on the page and then select Inspect. From the right hand panel that appeared, click the three dot menu, then select More Tools. Then go to the Network Condition. And at the bottom of the screen, uncheck Use Browser Default under User Agent. And here you need to select Chrome OS. Now refresh the page. After refreshing, you will see the sections appear to select edition. Now close this, and from the drop down, choose Windows 10 Multi Edition and click Confirm. Then you need to choose the same language you used in Windows 11 and click Confirm again. Finally, select 64-bit download and your Windows 10 setup file will start downloading. I have already downloaded that setup file. Once the download is complete, right-click on that file and select Mount. This creates a virtual DVD drive containing the Windows 10 files. And you will see files including setup.exe here. So simply right-click on that file and choose Run as Administrator. And click Yes when prompted. The Windows 10 setup windows will appear and say Install Windows 10. So click Next to continue, then accept the license agreement. Now it will ask you to choose what to keep. You can keep your personal files and apps if you want, but I am going to select nothing and click Yes. After that, it will start checking for updates. Here it will take some time to check everything. After a while, you will see a screen saying Ready to install with Windows 10 Pro, and the options keep nothing. If you are ready to continue, just click on Install and the installation process will begin. You will now see the installation process in percentage. This part can take several minutes. Okay, so I will fast forward this section so you can get a quick overview without waiting for the entire process. So during the installation, your PC will restart several times as Windows copies files, install features and drivers and prepares for the first use. So don't turn off your PC, just wait patiently for the installation to finish and then complete the setup experience. After that, you will be asked to choose your region. So select your country and click Yes. Next, choose your keyboard layout and click Yes again. When it asks for a second keyboard layout, just keep it. Then go ahead and connect to your network to continue the setup. After a while, you will see the how would you like to set up this device screen. Select Setup for a personal use and click Next. Then you will be asked to add your account. So click on Offline Account at the bottom. After that, you will see a message saying sign in to enjoy the full experience. Just choose limited experience. Now give a name of your PC and click Next. On the next screen, it will say always have access to your files. Click Accept. You can disable all privacy settings if you prefer and continue. Then on the Let's Customize Your Experience screen, just click Skip. When asked about Cortana, choose Not Now. After a few minutes, your desktop will appear and you will officially back on Windows 10. So you have successfully downgraded from Windows 11 to Windows 10. Now you can enjoy the familiar look and feel of Windows 10 along with the stable performance you are used to. Okay. So let's quickly verify the versions again. So the same way, press Windows plus R, and here you need to type Winver and hit Enter. And here you can see the current version showing Windows 10 2.2.2. So finally, let's check activation. And you can see it shows Windows is activated with a digital license, which means you have downgraded without losing your license. And that's it, guys. If this video helped you out, smash that like button. Drop a comment if you have any, and subscribe for more video like this. Thanks for watching, and I will catch you in the next video.